सर आई विल नाउ कम टू द ग्रेट लैक्यूना और ड्रॉबैक्स इन दिस स्कीम ऑफ टैक्स ऑन डिविडेंड्स बिकॉज इट हैज़ टू बी कंसिडर्ड ओनली ऑन द पेड अप कैपिटल. Sir, many concerns are undercapitalized. Many concerns have 10 times more in the reserves than in the capital, or even 20 times more, and the price of equity shares is governed by the reserves and capital. The same thing is seen in the case of the banking companies where they are called own funds. So whether it is capital or whether it is reserves, I think, sir, they should be treated on par. I do not know why the finance minister has taken this attitude of not taking the paid up capital and reserves together. On the basis of having the paid up capital and reserves together, he would have made the slabs narrower than what they are today. Today, the slabs are 6% to 10% and 10% to 18% and over 18%. If he had taken both items together, then the slabs would have been narrower, but that is ultimately the scientific structure, in my opinion, for levying taxes on dividends. After having taken this step, I would request him to do one more thing. If people make an application for converting reserves into capital, permission should be given very generously. There should be no hindrance in the way of companies converting their reserves into capital. Such a change would serve the purpose that we have in view, because once the reserves are converted into capital, they will be used only for expansion, for renovation, and for reconditioning. They will be used in a manner which will serve the cause of the country, because if the capital is to be reduced subsequently, then permission or sanction of the government is required. Therefore, sir, I suggest that ultimately return should be calculated on paid up capital and reserves put together, and this is more scientific. Sir, let us see what good will be achieved by this tax on dividends. Either people will pay taxes on dividends, or they will plug back the profits into industry, and by this process industrialization will not be retarded, but in my opinion it will be accelerated. People will be forced to plug back their profits for fear of having to pay more. Sir, it may be said that the finance minister is very hard on industry at present, and it has been said so in many quarters, but we have to look to one concession that he has given in clause 6 regarding section 23. He has reduced the percentage of distribution from 60 to 50. I think, sir, this is a very welcome feature. This was overdue, because if industrial concerns want to plug back the profits for expansion or for reconditioning and renovation, they should be allowed to do so. This gives us an idea about his inclination, which is that the country should be industrialized at a fast pace, and on this account he has given this concession. He is giving exemptions in certain cases in order that the concerns may expand by not distributing any dividend. In giving such exemptions, I hope he will be very generous. Now, sir, I would come to the third point about depreciation allowance, development rebate and compulsory deposit. This has been a very controversial point amongst the industrial and business circles, and rightly so. In the bill as it has been drafted, government have taken too much power for asking concerns to deposit a percentage on account of profits and gains before the 30th of June if certain conditions exist regarding reserves, fixed assets, and so on. He has done this with a purpose, and I quite understand it, but the way in which it is put is simply embarrassing to those who are carrying on business and industry. He has assured us that he will use this power in the most liberal manner, but the assurance could very well have been implemented by having some changes in the clause which has been brought before the House, because this deposit has to be made before the 30th of June. Because it has to be made before the 30th June, you know that 90% of the concerns are borrowers, and a borrower cannot be asked to deposit earlier. Therefore, 1 month before, let him know that so much profits and reserves would be exempted. A borrower cannot be asked to make a compulsory deposit. Sir, although the Honorable Minister has assured us that he will be very liberal in this connection, I feel that it should have been in the bill itself rather than in the rules, if he at all means that.